Again, on stage door in Nashville, it's been several weeks since we had this gentleman, but he's been around the Grand Ole Opry and the recording industry in Nashville for a long time. Your friend, I know, George Morgan. Hi, George.
Fine, Bob. How are you?
Nice to see you again, friend.
Thank you, sir. It's nice to see you. Always glad to see you here at stage door.
That is exactly right tonight.
And that's exactly where we are, isn't it? Right down below the steps of the stage of the Grand Ole Opry.
George, where have you been lately?
Well, I've been to Virginia and Connecticut and Pennsylvania and, Iowa.
Well,
I'm going to Kansas City as soon as I get through talking to you.
We're in every state except Connecticut. You'll have to speak a word for us up there. We're in every other state now.
All right, we'll have to do that, Bob. Listen, it's a pleasure talking to you, and I wish you much success with your show.
Well, George, we're working hard, just like a lot of other people I know. I know you've worked hard a long time. For the last 20 years, I think I've known you 20 years.
At least. Right. We want to say how many more.
No. George, how about singing a song for us?
All right. How about singing my latest stop recording, We've Done All the Lovin' We Can Do?
Far away, any time of night or day, I needed you. But it's all over now. We've done all the loving we can do. At least I should forget the many hours that we spent walking through this world of ours, looking like a field of flowers round. But where have the flowers gone? We've done all the loving we can do. Just in case some summer morning you should wake and find the fragments of a memory still a-hanging in your mind, just pass it off as something that's not worthwhile to pursue. We've done all the loving we can do. Maybe it's because we loved a little bit too hard, never stopping to consider the heart can turn so bitter when love leaves you. But where has it gone? All the love we can do. Just in case some summer morning you should wake and find the fragments of a memory still a-hanging in your mind, just pass it off as something that's not worthwhile to pursue. We've done all the loving. The heart can turn so bitter when love leaves you. But where has it gone? We've done all the loving we can do.
George, that's a great song, and I think really one of the best that you've done. Of course, I still prefer Candy Kisses. That's a great song for me.
Well, thank you. I'm kind of partial to it myself.
George, we've got most of your Star Day, because you're not on Star Day now, but you don't mind me saying this.
No, not at all.
You have a bunch of Star Day albums. I have a bunch of them. As a matter of fact, Hal and I signed a little agreement. You knew that I made a Moonshot album for it.
No,
really,
I
for
didn't.
Star Day, they put it on King.
Well, wonderful.
It's really pretty, George. I'll try to save you a copy of it.
I wish you would, Bob. Bring me one next time you come to the opera.
Well, now, when I bring it up here, you won't be here, and when I don't bring it, you will be. That's the way it works.
Well, let's take a chance
okay,
anyway.
Okay, George.
Bob, thank you for letting me talk.
Thank you. George Morgan, Stop Records and the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville. Back in just a moment after this message from your local announcer. Well, friends, we really have a special treat for you today on Stage Door. Actually, one of the finest singers I know, and when you catch Ernest Tubb off the road enough to sing a couple of songs for you, you've really done a job. Some of the old-time Ernest Tubb songs, you know, a few years ago, Ernest and I worked together on the Ernest Tubb Ray Price Jamboree. I was producing the show, and I think, frankly, it was one of the highlights of my life, so far as I'm personally concerned. I think Ernest enjoyed it because we did serve a lot of radio stations. Let's bring in Ernest Tubb and have a couple of songs. Ernest, give us a couple of good old-time Ernest Tubb songs.
Here's a song for you, one called I Cried a Tear. I cried a tear because of you. I cried a tear because we're through. I cried a tear. What else could I do but cry and sigh for love of you? I felt a tear fall in my heart. You fooled me so. I wasn't smart. I can't believe that we must part. Come back to stay. Let's make a new start. Oh, but Emily. Cried a tear because of you. I cried a tear because we're through. Please make my dream of you come true. Don't make me cry for you. Don't make me cry a tear for you.
Thank you. Here's one of Johnny Bond's songs that I recorded several years ago called I'll Step Aside. Step aside for you if you don't want me. I'll step aside for you if you don't care. I'm not the one to cling to a broken promise. I'll step aside for someone else somewhere. I'll step aside for you if you don't want me. I'll step aside for you and you alone. And when I'm gone, just promise you'll remember that I was once your darling all your own. Billy Bird now. Before you go, please answer this last question. As you gaze into my tear-dimmed eyes,
might be true. You never cared about me. And all those words I treasured were just lies. I'll step aside for you if you don't want me. I'll step aside for you and you alone. And when I'm gone, just promise you'll remember that I was once your darling all your own.
Ernest Tubb, boy, I'll tell you one thing. He certainly sounds just like he did. Ernest, you sound now like you did, well, we won't say how many years ago. We'll be back in just a moment. Thanks a lot, Ernest, for those songs. Real old-timers that brought back some real memories. After this 60-second message, we'll be back with more Stage Door Nashville. Well, friends, here on Stage Door Nashville in Nashville, Tennessee, we have one of the loveliest ladies in country music, Miss Loretta Lynn. She's in country music and in the rodeo business. Hi, Loretta.
Hi. I don't know if I can talk after that introduction there.
I'd say we saw you on the new TV show the other night.
Hee-haw.
Hee-haw.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yes, I saw that. My hair looked terrible.
Well, I thought it looked great.
I had my hair down all day the day we filmed that from 6 o'clock. From 9 o'clock to 6 that evening, and I didn't get around doing my part till 6 o'clock that evening.
We were up there one day on the session, but tell me when that was there that day, but not you. Loretta, tell us, you were originally from Kentucky, right?
Kentucky.
What part of Kentucky?
Down in the eastern part. My daddy was a coal miner. He worked in the Van Leer coal mine.
How far are you from Tompkinsville?
Not too far.
How about Georgetown? We have Georgetown is just out of Lexington.
Well, now I live about 70 miles from Lexington. Paintsville, Prestonsburg, Pike, yeah. Around in that area.
Whitesburg.
Yeah.
And E.T. and Hank Snow own a radio station up at Whitesburg,
yeah.
Or they did.
Yeah.
Loretta, it's been nice to have you with us today, hon, and I hope your rodeo will do the greatest.
Oh, my goodness, don't break them.
Can't afford to break those seeing our dogs,
right.
Can't.
Right.
How about introducing this next Loretta Lynn song for us?
All right, let's do the brand new one, okay?
Right.
To make a man feel like a man, you gotta show him you're a woman. When he comes home from a hard day's work, he's probably tarred and dirty. Don't let him find a slouchy queen, have his castle looking pretty. There's lots of things that you shouldn't do, but there's just as many that you should do too. To make a man feel like a man, you gotta show him you're a woman.
Great great song done by a great lady, Ms. Loretta Lee. And Loretta, that was fine, and certainly I enjoyed it very much.
Thank you very much.
Good luck on your records, your Grand Ole Opry, your shows, and your rodeo.
Thank you.
Come see us here.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Loretta Lynn of Decca Records, the Grand Ole Opry, and the Loretta Lynn Rodeo. We'll be back in a moment after this word from your local announcer. Here's a great treat that we've been waiting for a long time here on Stage Door Nashville. One of the older bands of the Grand Ole Opry that, well, maybe not one of the first ones, but one of the earlier ones, is Mr. Sam McGee. Hi, Mr. McGee.
Yes, sir. How are you doing?
Doing fine. How long have you been with the Grand Ole Opry?
43 years.
My goodness alive, that's a long...
Oldest man in captivity.
Well, I'll tell you what, I've been hearing you ever since I can remember, I'll say
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we've been here for 43 years, I have.
Right, and where's the brother tonight?
Kirk, he's here somewhere.
We don't see him around at the moment.
He's not in here right now, but he's...
You fellas,
he probably done gone, maybe.
You fellas remember Uncle Dave Makern and the Delmore brothers and... D. Ford Bailey,
yeah,
and many of them.
That's right.
Some of our listeners don't even know who we're talking about.
I played with Uncle Dave for 20 years.
Whatever happened to D. Ford Bailey? Do you remember?
He's still living, I think. He's here in Nashville somewhere. I think he runs a little shoe shine parlor back over in West Nashville.
A little short fellow, wasn't he?
Yeah,
a little short.
He
used to play a harmonica.
Yeah.
As Lonnie Glosson, the $1.98 boy, says, played a French harp.
He'll play two harps at one time.
I never did
one
see
in his mouth, and he'd have one under his nose.
Really?
A little bitty harp, yeah. Yeah.
And Mr. McGee, how about getting the fruit jar drinkers to strike up one? We haven't met you fellas on the show yet. What would you like to... How about introducing these fellas, by the way?
This is Hubert Gregory over here. He's the head of the fruit jar drinkers.
Come over, Hubert, just a minute. Hubert Gregory is... how long have you been with the fruit jar drinkers, Mr. Gregory?
About 27 years, something like that.
Well, I'm going to tell you something that at your age you'll probably appreciate. You don't look like you've been here that long.
Thank you.
Some of the other fellas, what is your name, sir?
Goldie Stewart.
Mr. Stewart, how long have you been with the fruit jar drinkers?
27.
27 years, my goodness. We have a visiting fiddle player here. Do you mind telling us who you are?
Walter Probst from Concord, North Carolina.
Oh, really? That's a fine town just outside of Charlotte.
Thank you. That's for 18 miles.
That'd be PEG, I believe.
That's right.
There you are. I was over in your territory about 3 or 4 months ago. It's a great territory. And your name, sir?
Clifton McGee.
Clifton McGee. Oh, you're the son of Sam?
My youngest son, yeah.
How many sons you have, Mr. McGee?
Well, I have three and living.
Three sons. Well, Lefty, it's nice to have you with us, too.
Okay, thank you.
You've been playing with Pappy for a long time?
For a good while.
All your life?
Enjoyed it. As long as he let me.
You are okay. Oh, yeah, the fruit jar drinkers, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if we can get a recording here. Yes, sir.
Our little program is a little bit confusing to a lot of people. We go as fruit jar drinkers, you know, till 11 to 11:30, and then we do a number, Sam and Kirk McGee.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, then you have actually Sam and Kirk McGee and the Fruit Jar Drinkers.
Yeah, that's right.
Combined,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
This is one of the older bands of the Grand Ole Opry, ladies and gentlemen. This is what the Grand Ole Opry was built on and still goes today. How about it, fellas? What are we going to do now?
How about the Leeson song, Leeson to the Mockingbird?
Leeson to the Mockingbird, all righty. Here it is. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is an old-time fiddle playing. Some of the bands don't carry them today, but they're still beautiful.
Thank you.
We have three guitars, a fiddle, and a big old bull fiddle. All sounded good. We'll be back in just a moment after this message from that star in your own hometown, your local announcer. Last week, friends, we started a memorial part of the stage door. It was the Delmore brothers, two of the Grand Ole Opry's finest artists who've gone on to the hillbilly haven. Today, we have another such artist, a man without whom the Grand Ole Opry would not nearly be so rich or country music, Cowboy Copas, who died in a plane crash several years ago. Cowboy Copas is from the state of Oklahoma, recorded for the King record people and then Starday when they bought out King, and worked with such great acts as Pee Wee King. He started with Pee Wee King's Golden West Cowboys and then brought his own Oklahoma Cowboys on the scene. One of the biggest hits that Cowboy Copas ever gave to country music, and one of the last ones. We'll play it for you now as we remember Cowboy Copas and Alabama. Cowboy Copas, one of country music's brightest stars, who's gone on to his reward. We like to remember some of the stars that helped to build and make country music. And certainly Cowboy Copas from Muskogee, Oklahoma, was one of the finest. Well, that's about all for this week. We'll be back with you on next Saturday from here at Stage Door Nashville at the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville, Tennessee. This is Bob Donovan, and now here's Bill Donovan to close us out. We'll see you next week, friends. Bill?
That's about it here on Stage with Nashville Bob, as you just said. And we are awful glad to have had the artist George Morgan, Ernest Tubb, Bobby Lloyd, the Fruit Jar Drinkers, Loretta Lynn, and Jack Green. Our thanks to all of them for helping make Stage Door Nashville what it is. And we'll see you again next week, same time on the same station, for Stage Door Nashville from Nashville, Tennessee. Bill Donovan for myself and Bob Donovan, seeing you again next week here on this radio station. Goodbye from Nashville.